going to show you how to tempo map in Pro Tools. This is one way you can do it. If you want to record an instrument live without a click and then add a click later, you can put it in record like so. Start playing. Then I've got it set up so that the grid lines are beats. There's a beat, there's a beat, there's a beat. And usually what I'll do is put it in slip mode and drag the first beat of my performance to the first beat in my grid. Put it back in grid mode here. So, and then by using Control I in Windows, I'll have to double check what it is in Mac. I'll post it, but this is going to be a Windows video. I'll do this later on the Mac. And I'll turn the click on and just mute my audio, and you can listen to the click. It doesn't line up. And here's the audio without the click. So, put my cursor on beat one of the next bar and pull it over. Make sure I'm going to count here again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. So my 1 wants to fall there. Hope that made sense. So I did Control I, added a beat, and then clicked on the next bar and did Control I and added a beat. And now I'm just going to kind of visually look for the next beat. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. So there's my 1. Put my cursor on the next beat, 1. Command I. Grab my tempo marker back there. Count again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. That one's about on, but I'll go ahead and do it anyway. And 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, well, beat 4, here's 1, 2, 3. Beat 4 is this guy. Put that on right there. Let's see if I did this right. I'm just gonna not turn the click on yet. 2, 3, 4. Okay, and in this case, since it's a retardando, I'll add a couple more beat markers like this. And drag them right onto the beats. And you can look as you go through, if you see some other tempo variations, you can do that too. You can correct a beat here or there. So if I turn on the click, here's what we now have.